Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Be Yourself. This is Dr. Rajni and today we will be discussing about the hydrophobic and hydrophilic interaction. In my last class, I already have discussed about the covalent and ionic interactions. So today I am continuing with the same series of the biochemistry and enter into the hydrophobic and hydrophilic interactions. So whenever I say hydrophobic and hydrophilic interactions, the water molecule is or the water or discussion of water is indispensable. Because this property is particularly related with the water molecule. So when we talk about the water, so suppose you are pouring a water in a glass. If it happens that one molecule comes enter inside the glass, it is not so. Then how these molecules are packed together and how they are interacting? So suppose there are various molecules of water, they are moving together. And why they are moving together? Because they are being associated with one another through the hydrogen bonding. So this is because of the connection of hydrogen bonding. Now we are talking about the hydrophobic and hydrophilic molecules. So how we can distinguish between a hydrophobic and hydrophilic molecules? Suppose, before that, one more thing is that our oxygen is here partial negative charge, as I have discussed in my last class, and hydrogen is here partial positive charge. So there may be possibility that this negative charge of one oxygen molecule will be repelling the nearby negative charge of the oxygen molecule. Similarly, the plus charges will be repelling each other. But even in spite of that, they are held together by the hydrogen bonding. So what is actually force which is overcoming this repulsive force? The answer lies here in the electrostatic force. So we know that in electrostatic force, E is directly proportional to the charges but inversely proportional to the distance between the two charged molecules. So here if we will see the distance between the hydrogen and oxygen, though I have put here a big distance, but it is not so. Hydrogen being very small in size and oxygen as compared to oxygen. So distance between oxygen and hydrogen will be very less, and this small distance will lead to the higher electrostatic force. So because of this higher electric force, this will overcome the repulsive charges which will be there in between oxygen and oxygen and hydrogen and hydrogen. Now how we will be distinguishing the polar and non-polar solvent? Suppose I have added salt in water, then what will happen? Partial negative charge of oxygen will be attracted toward the partial charge of oxygen will be attracted toward the positive charge of the sodium, whereas partial positive charge of the hydrogen will be attracted toward the negative charge of the chlorine, and this will help the mixing of or dissolution of salt in the water solution. So the one which will be dissolved in the water will be termed as the polar substance. So suppose I have put a drop of oil in the water, then what will happen? To minimize the surface area, the water molecule will be surrounding the non-polar molecule. But this does not a very stable condition. So it is will be having some hydrophobic effect between the oil and water. So suppose here we have two non-polar molecule together, then what will happen? In presence of water, the water will be present or will be surrounding itself around this non-polar molecule to minimize its energy and surface area. So what happens to minimize its energy and to have a stable entropy? These two non-polar molecule will come together and will release more amount of water molecule so that they can interact with one another. And this property is quite useful when we are using liposomes to deliver the drugs and in our body. So you can see you in the oil and water interaction, you might have seen that the two oil drops will be migrating toward each other, and what happens at last, they got fused with one another to form a big round surface of the oil in water to minimize its surface area. Now, how this hydrophobic and hydrophilic effect is useful inside our body? So, very good example is the phospholipid layer, which is the outermost layer of the cell. And suppose we have put some of the phospholipid inside the cell, then what will happen? As soon as they will come in contact with the outer hydrophilic or the water media, they will minimize its surface area in such a way that the hydrophilic head will be exposing outside the cytoplasm, and the nonpolar phospholipid tails will be exposing towards each other, and this helps to maintain the integrity of the cell and also assist in the transportation of some hydrophobic elements across the cell also. It also assists in the proper folding of the protein. And you know that in plasma membrane there are some proteins are also present there. So suppose this is the peripheral protein, there may be some integral protein will be also there, and there are different amino acids which also differ in their polarity. So on this basis, how the protein will fold together itself, the folding will be controlled in such a manner that if the protein will be integral, then the outermost layer of the amino acid will be maximum containing the hydrophobic amino acid, whereas the one which is present in the periphery will be containing the hydrophilic amino acid. So to maximize its interaction, such types of folding of the protein take place. Another very good example of role of hydrophobicity inside our body is that generation of liposomes, which will be covering drug inside it. So it also helped in the proper delivery system of our body. So liposomes not only used in the drug delivery, but if you will remember the fusion or in the plant cells, if you remember, we use PEG cells to fuse two protoplasts together. We use the PEG to fuse two set of protoplasts together to form a hybrid cells. So in this way, hydrophobic and hydrophilic interactions are playing a very vital role in our body or to maintain the structure of the biomolecules. Okay, so all these were about the hydrophobic and hydrophilic interactions. So don't forget to subscribe and share my channel, because from tomorrow we will be starting with the new module, which is the carbohydrate, and from here the basic biochemistry starts.